In this video, I'm going to show you the best way to track and analyze your business statistics using just a spreadsheet. Hey everyone, Megan here from MeganMins.com, where I help busy entrepreneurs like you save time running their business. As a business owner, it's really important that you are collecting data about your business growth. This will allow you to see trends and analyze what is and isn't working in your business. Plus, you'll be able to make smart decisions about what to do next. That's why I'm going to show you the exact spreadsheet and process I use to not only gather and collect data, but to analyze it. Okay, so now you're looking at the business statistics tracking spreadsheet that I use in my business. There are three tabs that I'm gonna walk you through: goals, growth, and log. And I'm gonna talk you through what you need to do to track your statistics, how you're gonna analyze them for your business. And I'll even show you how you can actually snag these exact same spreadsheets so you don't have to figure out all the formulas yourself. So the first thing you want to do when it comes to tracking your business statistics is go ahead and set some goals. What I track is my email list, so the number of subscribers on my email list, the number of followers on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook for my business page, that's important, and my Pinterest followers. For me, YouTube is a big emphasis in my business right now, so I'm definitely tracking my YouTube subscribers. And I actually don't have a Facebook group right now, but one of my clients does, so I wanted to make sure that this was included for tracking her business statistics. And I know a lot of you do use Facebook groups to help grow your business, so I definitely wanted to include this. Now, you can actually change the names of these to be whatever you want if you want to track different things. That's totally fine. Okay, so what you'll want to do is go ahead and drop in these goals. So I'm going to go ahead and drop in my goals for these real quick. Okay, so I just went ahead and dropped in some demo goal numbers here really quick. And you can see that automatically this has been updated as well, which is just great. I love when that happens. And we're going to actually come back to this tab once we go through the other tabs, because really, once you set your goals, the rest of this is happening automatically. So we need to actually drop in some data for us to see how this all plays out. But the first thing you want to do is set those goals. Okay, so I'm actually going to jump to this third tab, the log tab, because an essential part of tracking your business statistics is taking the time to actually log them. Now, this spreadsheet has made it super easy. It takes me just 1 or 2 minutes a week or anytime I go to log this, so it's very simple and very quick. All you need to do is input the date, so I'm going to put today's date, and then go ahead and quickly drop in however many subscribers or followers you have on each platform right now. Okay, so I just quickly dropped in stats that are somewhat similar to mine. And then under notes, since this is the first time I am tracking my notes, maybe I would just put what I do on a recurring basis. So what you'll want to do is set a recurring task for how often you're going to log your data. I like to do once a week just because it's super easy and I don't usually forget because I just have a recurring task in my project management system. What I really want to emphasize is that you should have some kind of frequency with this, because just the more consistent you can be, the better. And really take advantage of documenting what you're doing differently. So maybe if there's 1 week where I suddenly sent out 3 emails because I was promoting something, I would make a note of that so I could see what else happened. So definitely take the time to fill out the notes section. You can see how quick and easy that was for me to fill this out. It's not a hard process. So now we get to move to the fun tab called the growth tab. What this spreadsheet is gonna do, again, you don't have to touch it, it's happening for you automatically. It's gonna pull the last entry for each month and tell you, and it's gonna go and drop in whatever that number was here. So maybe you logged once a month or 10 times a month, it's gonna pull that last piece of data for that month and drop it here. And then it's also going to assess your growth month to month, as well as your overall growth from the first time you started tracking to the last piece of data. So you'll see this for each social media or platform we're tracking, and then underneath is a visual representation of that growth. I'm a visual person, so seeing spikes and decreases visually helps me more. So let's go ahead and jump over to the built out version. So in this demo, again, we just have some random numbers pulled in. You can see our log is a little bit more fully fleshed out. You can see these random numbers. Just looking at this log isn't as meaningful as seeing it broken down in this growth. So I can see some pretty consistent trends here. Again, that's because it's demo content. So I was just kind of putting in some demo numbers, but let's say all of a sudden we spike here to 1800 email subscribers within a week. I can see this spike really easily visually, and I can see it up here in the trends too, but it's much easier for visual, at least for me. So I would look back at my business and be like, what did I do in September? Because this is the last day of August I was here, and the last day of September I was here. So what did I do in September that caused such a big increase? And I could come back over here and say, oh, okay, I did 3 more videos, and I did a new giveaway, and I did this new challenge, and I launched my course. Wow, no wonder I saw all this growth. So this is where the notes really become more powerful and meaningful, as you can go back and see what caused certain spikes. Okay, so that's the growth tab. And all of this again happens automatically, which is just my favorite part. It's so fun to see it and see it visual and make it feel more tangible. So if we go back to that goals tab on our original spreadsheet, and if we come over here, we can see where we're at. So really, when I'm looking at the goals tab, yes, I can sit there and like read every line if I want, but I'm really kind of looking over here, just my current stat, the last piece of data that was put in. Where does that leave me, and how far away am I from hitting that goal? Okay, so that is how I track my business statistics. I take the time on a weekly basis to log the statistics. I look at the growth and see how I'm doing for that month and see where it's taking me and what's working and what isn't working. And then I look at my goals. This is always at a glance. I quickly check in and just see how am I doing? Where am I plateauing? What do I need to try something new? I think that's one of my favorite things to look at when the growth tab is I can see really quickly on a visual element with these charts, where am I plateauing? And am I okay with that? If I'm not really growing that rapidly on Pinterest, is that okay because I'm not focusing on it? Or is that bad because I'm focusing on it and everything I'm doing isn't working? So definitely take the time to create a chart like this, log your stats, have some visual aids that are making these assessments for you, and compare it all with your goals and see how you're doing. This is how you can really start to take just basic follower numbers and actually make smart decisions in your business, because you know where you're making an impact and where you're not. Now you know exactly how to track your business growth. But I understand if you don't want to take the time to recreate this spreadsheet yourself. So if you want to save yourself some time, and I'm sure you do, then you can actually download these exact spreadsheets right now. Just click the link in the corner of this video or below to find out more about how you can get these spreadsheets. Now I want to hear from you. Let me know in the comments below if you're going to be using these spreadsheets to track your business growth. And if you thought this video was helpful, please subscribe, share with your friends, and hit the like button below so I know to make more videos like this. I'll see you in the next one. Seven and a half minutes in and I have recorded like one sentence. Just making last minute notes. Wasting film and battery.